Hi! For the next few minutes, I'm going to talk about some specific ways on how we can effectively manage learning at home. At the same time, how we can assess ourselves to aid our learning process. By the way, I am Teacher Jolly from Teacherella Diaries. I produce contents for students, teachers, and job seekers. So if you are struggling with, say, writing your essay, or if you are a graduating student who will be applying for a job in the near future, I have some videos in my channel for you. I'm very excited to share some specific distance learning tips and ways that you can see and try for yourself. Number one, create a learning space that is not where you rest. Why is it important to create a learning space? Well, it's essential to establish a psychological divide between school and home. I know exactly how it feels to be studying and reviewing on your bed 1 minute and then
sleeping
the next minute. Relate ako dyan. When you study on your bed, you know how cozy and homey it makes you feel. Now, I don't have a specific theory to back this up right now, but I know you get my point. When you study on a place where you rest, naturally your body will tell you to rest. So assigning a specific spot in your house where you can have study time will be very helpful for you. Ma'am, I don't have a big house full. Does it have to be an entire room? Nope. Does it have to look like a library or something? Nope. A learning space could be just a small table in a corner where you can sit and put the things that you need for learning. Number two, find a learning buddy. We love to do a hobby or any activity with someone, right? Well, it's the same principle. A learning buddy is a partner for studying. Could be a friend, preferably a classmate, or someone who is currently taking the same course or subject. Actually, I saw this from one of my former students. She posted a picture where she's studying with another person through Zoom. Now, why do this? Why have a learning buddy? There will be days when you won't feel motivated to do your task or project. And that's okay. There will be lazy days because you know how Miss Procrastination works. Having a learning buddy will help you keep track of the task on hand. Your buddy can remind you, hala, hindi pa natin ito natatapos, hindi ka pa nakakapagbasa ng certain requirement na ito for this subject. In the same way, you can also provide support to your partner with his or her tasks. It's a give and take kind of support system. It will make you feel that you are doing the task with someone who shares the same experience. Makes you less overwhelmed and less anxious. Okay, so how does this work? Basically, you just have to set up a time where you can meet online. Could be through Zoom, could be through Google Meet, Discord, or even Facebook Messenger. It's really up to you kung ano ang gusto niyong gamitin. And walang strict rules. Kung napapagod na kayo mag-aral for 45 minutes, you can take a break, you can watch an episode together, or listen to music, or even eat your merienda at the same time. Third one, allot time for rest and other activities. I cannot emphasize this even more. Let's avoid getting burned out. Alam mo yung ubus na ubus ka na, wala ka ng drive para gawin ng isang bagay. It's probably because sa buong araw mo, nag-aral ka lang. You did not even take a break, take a nap, or have a me time. Ang me time ay ang oras na inilalaan mo para sa iyong sarili. Pwedeng itong oras na ito ay nagbabasa ka lang ng manga, o nanonood ka ng k-drama, o nagluluto ka ng merienda. Sa school nga, di ba, may recess at break. So sana kahit distance learning tayo, we still a lot of time to rest and a time to do other things. Also, this is one of the questions that was given to me. Sabi niya, how can we manage our small businesses while studying at home? How can we keep it balanced? Firstly, sa nagtanong nito, I want to say that doing business, even just a small business, is really time-consuming. I know that because I'm currently co-managing a small business. There are a lot of things that you have to do on your own when you're just starting up, including branding, marketing, product research, restocking, and customer service. So if you badly want to put up a business while you're still in college, my advice would be doing time blocking. Time blocking is dedicating specific time blocks for certain tasks. So ano po ang difference ito sa to-do list? Ang to-do list kasi ay listahan lamang ng mga gagawin. But when you do time blocking, the time when you need to do it is also indicated. Ito ang isa sa mga dahilan kung bakit tayo natataranta o parang na-overwhelm tayo sa lahat ng mga gagawin. Kasi alam natin na ang lahat ng ating gagawin for a certain day. But we do not know kailan natin ito gagawin. Ending, pinagsasabay-sabay mo lahat gawin. Which is wrong. When you schedule properly, there's a lesser tendency to get distracted. Because you know you have allotted a time to do that certain task. Hindi ka na mag-worry na hala, hindi pa ako nakapag-post sa aking page. Or hala, hindi pa ako nakapag-check ng aking email. Dahil alam mo na meron kang inilaan na oras para doon. Now, you'll be just focusing with one task at the moment. Ngayon ma'am, ang totoo po kasi ay medyo nag-i-struggle ako sa aming online class. Hindi po ako fast learner. To answer that, let's go to number 4. Adjust to your learning needs. We have to understand that every person has a different dominant learning style. Some are dominantly visual learners, auditory learners, or kinesthetic learners. Say you are a dominantly visual learner, which means you learn better by seeing information presented in meaningful symbols or graphs. What you can do to help yourself learn better is to write and draw. What I would suggest is using graphic organizers. So for example, during an online discussion, your teacher was talking about different learning theories. What you can do is to draw a concept map like this. At the center circle, you're gonna write learning theories. And inside the surrounding circles, you'll write the types of learning theories and a very brief discussion per theory. So this is only an example. What's good about this is you're helping yourself to organize information in your head and comprehend the very concept of each theory. We are not merely memorizing, but we are practicing understanding the concepts. Another example, if you are dominantly an auditory learner, what you can do is read aloud the text on your module, or you can discuss or have a conversation with someone about the topics of what you are reading. The point here is we have to intentionally take actions that will aid our learning style or learning process. According to Edgar Dale's cone of experience, we remember 10% of what we read and 20% of what we hear. But we remember 70% of what we say and write and 90% of what we do. Leading us to point number 5. Practice active learning. Active learning is when you think about what you're doing and involve yourself with meaningful activities. There are a lot of active learning strategies that you can try, like generating questions. Create a question about a topic and then answer it later on, or ask your classmate or ask your teacher. Next, drawing illustrations. Based on the information that are presented to you or based on the discussion that your teacher did, you can try to create and draw illustrations like graphs or maps. Next, note-taking. Note-taking does not mean copying the entire material. Note-taking is a skill where you are able to filter the most important information and summarize the key points by writing it down. Lastly, reteaching the concept to your peer. ituturo mo ulit sa kaklase mo kung ano yung natutunan mo. Listen to this. When you are able to fully explain the concept to your peer, that simply means you understood it. And for me, that's the highest form of active learning. That's all for today. I hope you are able to take away something useful or relevant from this quick talk. Try these tips and see what will work best for you. Feel free to check my other videos on my channel at Teacherella Diaries. Happy learning! Bye-bye!